In Unit 3 of this course, you will learn about implementing cascading style sheets, or CSS, to beautify the code you created in the previous unit. Splitting the form and content in this way allows you to make aesthetic changes to your pages without having to wade through miles of code. It also helps you maintain consistency in the appearance of your pages. For example, if you want to change the color of your headlines, you only have to make one change to the style sheet, and all instances of that headline on the page will change as a result. The change I just showed you was very slight, but style sheets can actually have a profound impact on every aspect of the site's aesthetics. Take a look at this page. By simply selecting a new style sheet, notice how it looks like it belongs to an entirely different website now, when in fact the underlying code wasn't altered in any way. In this unit, you'll learn how to add in-page styles by inserting the style tag into your web pages. As your stylistic skills advance, it's possible to split your style sheet off into a separate document, but for the purpose of this unit, you'll be keeping the style sheet as part of each individual page. Notice how the style tag works. You've got the selector, which is the individual page element you're formatting, and then a set of properties, which describe that particular selector in some capacity. Each property has a value or unique setting that specifies how you'd like that element displayed on your page. Style sheets can contain many, many such settings. So how do we know what properties are available for a given selector? Fortunately, there are online glossaries available that can give you the lowdown on properties for all common selectors. Later in the unit, we'll talk about how to use CSS to aid you in laying out your page. To this end, the div, or division tag, is handy for splitting your page into individual components so that you can apply particular styles to only one part of a page. A division tag can feature both a class as well as a unique ID. The divisions class is a special grouping mechanism that lets you apply the same style settings to multiple divisions, while the ID can be used to target a particular division's individual differences. By using these two arguments in concert, you can describe all divisions to a T without having to retype a lot of information. Lastly, you will learn how a traditional use of data tables was for laying out your page. Just make your borders invisible, and you've got yourself a layout tool. This function has been largely supplanted by CSS, which requires comparatively little code, is much easier to update and maintain, and is more accessible for screen reader users. Nevertheless, tables have been widely used for layout on the web, so this final lesson will at least allow you to recognize table layouts in someone else's code.